Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to make some radial gradient graphic styles with and without texture that you can use in your projects in Adobe Illustrator over and over again. So let's move to a blank document and get started. The first thing I'll do is create a circle, come to the left toolbar, click on the rectangle tool in the flyout menu. I'll choose the ellipse tool. It's keyboard shortcut L, and I'm going to hold down the shift key to drag out a perfect circle. Then I'll come over to the properties panel and click on the color fill icon, and then choose the black and white gradient, which gives me a linear gradient, and that means I have white on one side and black on the other. And I want this to be radial, where the white is in the center and the black is all the way around the edges. I can change this by clicking on gradient options. This opens up the gradient dialog box, and under type, right now I have linear gradient. I'm going to click on the center icon, which is the radial gradient, and now I have the white in the center and the black around the edges. And I can control how much white and how much black I have by grabbing hold of the gradient slider. If I want more white, I'm going to drag away from the white. That's actually increasing the amount of white. If I want more black, I'll drag away from the black, and that increases the amount of black. Well, this is too dark for me here. I'm going to come back and slide more to the right and give myself more white, and then I'm ready to create my first graphic style. So let's come up to Window and choose Graphic Styles. Now I'm going to set up a graphic style library just for gradients, so I'm going to delete these first, but if I click on any of these, I'm going to actually be applying a graphic style to my circle. So let's get the selection tool and click on the artboard to deselect this first. Then I'll select this first graphic style, hold down the shift key, and select the last one to select all of them. Come down and click on the trash can on the bottom bar and delete these graphic styles. And now I'm going to grab hold of this circle and drag it into the graphic styles panel, and I'll double click here to give it a name. So I'm just gonna put light gradient and say okay. Next, without changing the settings so far, I'm gonna come up to effect, down to texture, over and down to grain. Now, I've played around a lot with the grain options, and you will probably want to do the same. But what I've settled on is an intensity and contrast of 50 each, and I like the sprinkles grain type. There's a pull-down menu, and you can look at all the rest of these. I'm going to leave this at sprinkles and say okay. And you see now we have a really nice sprinkled texture all the way around the outside of the circle. So I'll grab this circle and drag it next to the other graphic style, and then I'll double click this and name it light texture gradient and say okay. Now I'm going to delete this circle, and we'll create a brand new one, give it a lime green fill color, and then I'll remove the stroke and create a copy. So I'll come up to edit, copy, edit, paste in place, and that copy is placed in front of the previous circle, so I can go ahead and click on the graphic styles. Illustrator applies the graphic style, but I'm not seeing my color through it. So I'll come over to the properties panel and click on opacity, and I'm going to change the blend mode here from normal to multiply. And when I do that, Illustrator allows the color to show through the gradient wherever there is white. So we see a lot of the lime green showing through. Now, if I don't want this black color here and I want a different green, I have to get the gradient tool. So we'll come over and click here or use the keyboard shortcut G, and I'll double click on the black and apply a different color. And then let's look and see what that looks like. And for some reason, I have a stroke again. Let me remove that. I have a very nice, soft, and smooth gradient that shows the green on the outside and that lime green on the inside. And if I don't want this darker color to be so prominent, I can select it and I can change the opacity. I'll type in 50% and click on the artboard. And that looks really nice. All that came from this graphic style right here. Now, to apply the graphic style that has the light texture, let's click here on that upper layer and apply the light texture. And once again, we have the black and white gradient, and I want to see through it. So I'll come over and click on opacity again, change the blending mode from normal to multiply. Here I see the lime green through where the white was. To change the black color, I'll come over and get that gradient tool and double click on the black. And let's try this green right here. And then I'm going to get the selection tool and I'm going to remove the black. Don't know why I keep getting a stroke here, but I don't want the stroke. And that's looking really nice. If I want this to be a little lighter, I can change the opacity. Let's drop it down just a little bit. It actually makes the grain look darker when you start playing with it after you've applied the effect. And what I've discovered is if you move it and move it back, you end up having the result that you want. Now, there are other ways to customize your gradient. Let me just show you one more. I'll select this upper layer, come back over and double click to get the gradient tool, and I'm going to grab hold of the line and I'm going to move it to the right. And Illustrator is actually changing where the center point of the radial gradient is. And again, the texture looks darker. I'm going to move it away and move it back, and that smooths it out. And you can see how now the center of the radial is moved off center on the circle. Now, if I want to save these graphic styles for use in other projects, what I need to do is come up to the icon in the top right corner of the graphic styles dialog box and come down to Save Graphic Style Library. And Illustrator is going to automatically take you to its default graphic styles folder. I recommend that you find another place to save your libraries that you create or that you maybe purchase, so that if you have a software crash, you don't lose all of those as well. So for now, I'm going to come to desktop and I'll create a new folder and I'm going to name this Susan's Gradients. And click create, and then I'll save this as light gradients and click save. Now when I go to another document, let's just create a new one here, and I open graphic styles, I won't see them in the default graphic styles, but I can come up to the icon again, open graphic style library, and choose other library. And Illustrator is going to take you to the default Illustrator graphic styles setting, but I placed mine on the desktop under Susan's gradients. Let me open this up. I'll choose light gradients and say open, and here my gradients are open in their own special tab, ready to be used. Well, I hope that you've enjoyed this video and learned some things about creating gradients that you can use in Illustrator over and over again. I want to invite you to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so that you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.